All right, hey there, small town America. So, you know, some of the guys that don't get the credit that they deserve, the credit that they need, are our bullfighters. And here at the World Finals, that we have a team of them, because these guys have been running from the mutton busting right into the calves, into the junior bulls. These guys are running all day long, nonstop. And we're going to take a chance, trying to get over here. We're going to meet the team. We're going to follow them around today, and we're just going to see what it is the bullfighters do. You know, they are the arena safety. They're not only watching for the Cowboys, they're watching for the animal, the athletes. They're looking at all the back judges. They're just trying to make sure that everything in the arena is safe. If you can't hang, don't bang. Let's go check them out.
How do y'all break this down when you got seven of you in here? I've noticed y'all have been kind of running some teams here, switching out. I mean, I understand, you know, like a fat guy like me would not be chasing the mutton button. That would not be done. Yeah, I would get two and be out. So how are you breaking down this whole team?
Man, we're mainly just running it to however we feel. If we're feeling a little worn out, we call somebody to pick it up. But we only do three guys at a time, so. You know, better chance to get in there, but we got four guys on the sideline at all times. So
keep everybody fresh.
Yeah,
everybody
fresh. I've also noticed y'all kind of wave them off there when you're feeling good. Yeah. Is that because you got a groove going, or
yeah.
Like that's a hey?
Feeling good right there. So
cool. How long have you been doing it?
I've been in it for almost 4 years.
Four? How long?
13.
13 years?
5 years.
5 years. Is the kids the funnest?
The hardest.
They definitely
roughest.
Well, I mean, we bucked out 360 kids last night. It was 7-7, no break. That's you guys are, and y'all got a little western last night. So cool.
As you can see, just kind of over and out. Your two main guys will really know what's going on. But it just makes everything a whole lot easier, and everything goes a whole lot smoother. And it's always fun working with three guys, because when you got a really mean bull, when you got three guys on him, they get super confused, and it just makes the job a whole lot easier.
Right.
It's all about smooth and everybody getting out safe.
Right. And so how long have you been doing this?
I've been doing this, 13 years now.
Wow.
Yes, sir. It's all for the love, man. You can't, you know, especially these youth kids. The kids are where it's at, you know. The kids keep the sports going. I don't mind coming out here and having fun.
I think a lot of you, because, you know, Flint, see these guys, and they kind of mistake you guys as being a clown,
right.
But you guys are like the total safety.
There ain't nothing funny about it.
Yeah, I see you guys pulling planks. I see the other day you had your head up in there trying to get that bull's attention focused back on you.
Man, whatever you can do to make everything smoother and help your buddies out, you know, the safer you are and the more you aware of things you are, you know, the better the event can go. And, you know, helping out here and there, that's where you get, you know, your jobs, you know. You don't really get your jobs. Like a lot of guys say, they don't hire bullfighters, they hire good help that know how to fight bulls. So if you're a good help and you can twist them up, you get a job in most places.
The deal is, because it's not just the rider, it's also the
production,
the stock.
Right,
you're
yeah.
And then the judges and the gate men and everybody else over there.
If you keep the production rolling and everything smooth, it's always a good time. It's always good to have three, though. That's just in case somebody gets out of position and you've got two people there at least,
right,
at minimum.
Well, and the other thing is, too, is you really kind of have to know the right. You have to. You can't just be a guy and then show up out here.
Oh, no.
You got to know whether it's time to move in.
It takes – when I first started fighting bulls, it took 2 or 3 years to – they call it being in the zone. I mean,
you get in that deal and you just like everything. Like when they say time slows down, it literally slows down. You just kind of get that groove and you know where to go, when to go. And it takes a couple of years and a lot of trial and error, that's for sure. A lot of misjudgment definitely gets you in the ball.
Shallow water, Texas. 239.
Like, Bull got super confused, three guys. He's like, what do I do? Where do I go? Who can I get? And he'll kind of just circle up, and he's like, he won't really pick anybody because he's like, oh, I can't really, you know, if I go to get this guy, somebody else can be right there. It just makes everything go a whole lot smoother.
You're one helper and a spotter. Get off the back of the bucket shoes, or we're done for the day.
You want a pair?
Judges can't do nothing. Might do nothing, they don't get off the back. Now I see 35 kids got up there and need to go. That's what they're feeling.
All about production.
From the lobby down, I thought these guys are getting the treatment during break.
You know, I can do that, but you know, I'm trying to do everything, so.
But man, these guys are really getting, they're working so hard, they're really getting the treatment.
It's day number three, man. How you feeling?
Oh, you know, a little sore, but you know, we're just blessed to be here. Happy to wake up this morning and do it all over again. We got another half day tomorrow, so we're just going to get it, the ball rolling and keep it going.
There you are, brother.
So.
All right, so, hey, Marcus, you know, a lot of sports, you'll hear them joke about, you know, hey, just rub some dirt on it and get back in the game. But we're actually in a sport where we rub some dirt on it and get right back in the game. I mean, our boy Anthony took a little bump yesterday, popped it right back in place, rubbed some dirt on it. He's out there pulling plank this morning. How does it – I mean, that's y'all's job is the safety, to take that – if you can't hang, don't take the bump, the bank, you know.
Man, so it all evolves, you know, about – this game is, like they say, it's 90% mental and 10% physical. I mean, if you can take a beating and get back up, the biggest deal for a bullfighter is, you know, getting over the fact of, hey, like, I might go in there, I might get my head ripped off, or it might be smooth and fun. But if I do get jammed up, I'm going to go back in there, do my job, and that adrenaline kicks in, and your mindset after fighting for so long, you're just like, hey, you know, like, wasn't that bad. I got knocked down, I'm back up, I'm here, I'm still breathing, you know, I got bumps and bruises, but I'm still able to go back at them. So in your mind, you don't want to give up, you know, you're here to have fun and make sure everybody's safe.
Right, and I think a lot of people don't realize, just, you guys have a servant's heart.
Yeah.
You don't even think about, you're fixing to get kicked, you're fixing to get, your automatic, your first instinct is to protect the Cowboys.
So the biggest deal is, man, how bad do you want to fight a fire? You know, do you want to see your friends go down and you're in the back, or do you want to go down with them? In the heat of battle, you know, especially all these kids and the parents, we know them, and they're just so close to us. It's like, you know, like for me and Andrew, you know, we've got kids ourselves, so our mindset is like, hey, you know, like, that's pretty much my kid. You know, you go into kind of like dad mode, and it's like, all right, well, let's go to battle. They're willing to go out there and have fun and go to battle, so are we, you know. Like, these kids put their life and their risk on the line a whole lot more than we do most of the time, you know, because they're the one tied in. I feel like we're a lot safer than they are, but, you know, if they're willing to take that risk, we're definitely willing to take it for them.
All right, three days of running and gunning, 12, 15 hours, how are you feeling?
Oh, we're definitely bumped and bruised. All the guys are sore. We've got YBR supplies, great medics. As you can see, I'm there on the spot, Candy. They've got everything we need, you know, to stay healthy and to keep going. And they take really good care of us. It's all about the teamwork and the support behind you, because you're definitely going to take some bumps and bruises through the week.
Yes, sir.
All right, brother.
Thank you.
Joke about, you know, get out there, rub some dirt on it, and get back in it. But we're actually in a sport where it is rub the dirt on it and get back in it. You took a little bump yesterday, and you're back out here pulling plank rope this morning, yanking kids off of the cows. Man, what does it mean to actually rub some dirt on it and get back in the game?
It's just hard and grit. You got to want it. And I'm here for the kids, so it's all about the kids to me. To make sure they walk out of here safe. I know I'm going to take some hits, but that's all about the kids. As long as the kids walk, get to go home safe in one piece. I did my job.
Right, and we were talking with Marcus. You know, a lot of people don't realize that you guys as the bullfighters really have to have a servant's heart.
Yeah.
Because you can't even think about, hey, I'm fixing to get kicked. I'm going to get you're literally throwing your body in the way for that. That's how amazing it is for you guys. And you don't ever get that recognition, but, you know, you guys are true servants, especially on protecting everything here. Not just the kids, but the animals also. Yeah. That's why I noticed you've been back there pulling the flank rope, making sure those ropes are set where they need to be set.
Oh, yeah.
Cool. Well, it's day number three. How are you feeling?
I'm a little beat up, but still going. Still going strong.
Now, right over your shoulder. Day three, how you feeling?
Day three, we're all a little beat down, a little sore, but the mood's just right. We're hungry, we're ready to fight some bulls.
So you put your hat on one nose.
What?
So you put your
hat
on
one nose. It's
gonna
be the one right here. Hat's going on. It's actually my good hat though, so maybe I'll take Marcus's hat off.
Yeah, hey, now that's the deal. Run over, grab Marcus's hat, put it on his nose. Notice they got y'all pickle juice.
It's good for cramps. We need it. I need some right now.
We'll be right back.
Marcus, how are we doing this day, man?
Oh, we're feeling it. That's the truth.
I'm telling you, everybody's got a little limp in it and all of that.
Everybody's back there praying that we only got 15 each event, not 55. That's for sure.
Yeah, but this is what it's all about, right?
Oh, yeah. This is the day we'll really have some fun. Everybody will turn it up. And they've got that extra go knob, and we'll turn it into four-wheel drive, and we'll get after it today.
That's awesome, man. Praying for you. Good luck, brother.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Day number four, everybody kind of bumped and bruised. How y'all guys feeling?
Feeling great.
They turning it up a notch today. You took a little bump yesterday. How you feeling?
Man, like $100.
You know, you always hear those war stories of the guys that jump on the grenade to save the face of the platoon. I mean, what goes through your mind when you know there's an explosion fixing to happen? Because you just like go, not even think twice, just go on somebody.
Man, better me than that kid.
There you go. And guys, as we were talking about with Marcus and them, about you guys, you got like a servant's heart. You don't even think about what's going to happen, that you're going to get horned or hooked or kicked or whatever. You just like automatically just jump in there and do your thing.
Yes, sir. Just react to it.
Let me down though. I kept waiting for you to put the hat on the nose. Throw.
Not this one. Maybe a different lid. I'm a good one.
Good luck today, guys.
Thank you. I'm like, you can't duplicate right there.
Hey, how you doing this morning?
Oh, man, we're feeling great. You know, about to get a show on the road. We got about
day four.
Yeah, we got about 85, 90 to get out today, so we're going to have a good little day. We're going to get it going.
We're day four. It's kind of fast and furious right now. It's a little bit more intense than the normal days because y'all are moving real quick. How do you adjust for that?
Well, you know, it's just kind of something we train to do. We got to change different gears for different events, different bulls. You just got to read what the cattle's doing, jump for jump, and you know, read how the rider's riding, and you know, just go with the flow. It's kind of like the ocean. Some days it picks up, some days it's kind of laid down. So,
right. Well, this being the top 15, it's not only the Cowboys, but they picked out the top 15 of the stock.
So, yeah, they've got the best of the best stock going right now. But that's the best of the best kids getting on. You know, these riders know what they're getting on. They know what they drew today. They got the pick. It just makes it, you know, like I like to make it more fun. I'd say, you know, you get to see who really wants it, who really get to see who they watched all week, what bucked best, and got to pick what they wanted, and they're trying their guts out.
Right.
Boy, ride. Go to work, son.
We got a thumbs up, and I'm telling you what, this is a tough.
Sometimes it just works out like that.
The potential.